I'm going to answer the question that has plagued humankind for millennia. If you're making a cup of tea, should you put the milk in straight away, or should you wait and add the milk at the absolute very last second? Now, some people will try and convince you that of course you have to put the milk in first because the tea tastes better that way. Well, actually, when people drink tea in a blind taste test, the best way to enjoy tea, they can't tell the difference. And so actually putting the milk in first was just a way to protect delicate cups. Whereas now, in our modern age of sturdy cupware, you can go as hot as you want, as fast as you fancy. Rock the Casbah. And so putting in the milk isn't a matter of taste or safety, it's merely a matter of which will keep your beverage the hottest for longest. Now, some people will wait. They will put the milk in at the absolute last second because they think that's going to keep it hotter. But that's not the case. If you look at the Stefan-Boltzmann equation for the rate at which a hot body radiates heat, it's based on the fourth power of its absolute temperature, so the temperature in Kelvin, minus the fourth power of the ambient temperature, again in Kelvin. What that means is hotter objects radiate more heat. Hot objects cool down faster, and because it's a fourth power, it makes a substantial difference. Something at 80 degrees Celsius compared to something at 100 degrees Celsius, the hotter 100 degree beverage will lose heat 1.5 times as fast. To put all of that into a plot, obviously when you add the milk early on, it does lower the temperature of your beverage, but then if you compare it to a beverage without milk, it will lose heat at a slightly slower rate. I mean, it's a bit difficult to tell, but there is a difference. What that means is later on, when you do add the milk to the other beverage, it drops below the original one. So it's definitely worth putting the milk in first and stemming the flow of that heat. So that's the idea in theory, at least. And I do get very excited because it's a fourth power. I love spotting fourth powers in the real world. If you have any more examples, please do let me know. But I want to know, does it actually work? And I even mentioned this in our recent BBC Radio 4 series. As Festal, the spoken nerd, we did a show for Radio 4 called Domestic Science, and I go on and on about fourth powers and cups of tea and all this. But I always thought, you know what? I have never actually checked. And so I have gone and bought a digital thermometer, which I can power up there, and it's got two different probes. Let me get the right one. This one here is T1. It's actually labeled as T. So I'm going to call this one here T1. I can put that probe in there. And this one here is T2. So I can put T2 in there. Oops, that's not great. I'm going to have to. All right, so now that is T1 not going anywhere from that cup. Over here we have T2. Not going anywhere from that cup. Now, at the moment, they should be registering about the same temperature. So actually, I can put this screen up so you can see it. And if you go through the different options, what we have at the moment is T1. We can switch to T2. You see, both the same temperature, T1, T2, pretty much the same. Over here, we've got T1 minus T2, which is currently zero. So if I actually heat up T1, if I put my finger on that and warm it up, you can see that number goes up. Now it's much hotter than the other one. And then in a second, that should cool back down again and we will be good to go. So just top that back up so it's definitely boiling. Now my theory is if we add the milk straight away to T1, it will cool down. So you will see the number go negative. But then later on, if we wait 5 minutes, and I add the milk to T2, it will drop below T1, and so we should then get a positive value. And that final positive number will be the number of extra degrees of warmth that we kept in T1 by putting the milk in straight away. So I've genuinely never tried this before. It may not work. Obviously, reality is much more complicated than theory, but we'll give it a go. Okay, so our initial temperature difference is pretty much zero. I'm going to put in the hot water into both and we'll let the tea brew initially. There we go. Cup of tea. gravity. Now let's just check the temperatures we've got going on. So if we come over here, T1 is 82, 81. It's cooling down a little bit. I guess the thermometer is, the sensor is getting used to it. Likewise, T2 is about the same. So they're both about 81 degrees. Wow, that is substantially, is one at the top and one, no, they're both at the bottom. 71, 77, 76. That's already quite a big difference. Why is there already a difference? Well, if I stir them, I'll stir them. Give it a stir. I'll take out the tea bag. Give this one a stir. Take out the tea bag. Okay, how are we doing now? So, oh, that's it. Okay, they're almost, they're within a degree of each other. That's better. Phew, had me worried. So 78 and about 70. Oh, they're both 78. Cool. Right, let's go back to the difference. Okay, so now they're the same temperature. I'm going to add the milk to T1 and then I will give it 5 minutes. So here we go, and the milk is in. Okay, so we have started a timer. I might actually give that a stir just for completeness. And so in theory, the temperature in T1, that's 10 seconds so far, has gone, look at that, it's negative 5 degrees. Okay, so initially, by putting in the milk, 30 milliliters of milk, I've dropped the temperature of this one by about 5 degrees, and we'll just, I don't know, we'll give it 5 minutes. That's 30 seconds so far, and then we'll come back and see how we're doing. Oh, I'm not gonna make you sit through the remaining 4 minutes and 20 seconds of waiting for the tea to adjust temperatures. I will skip through some of the highlights as such. If you want to watch the entire cooling process, as always, I will upload all the footage unedited onto my second channel. There's a link in the description. You can check it out in case you want all of this delicious data. 1:30, 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes, 3 minutes, 3.5 minutes, 4 minutes, 4.5 minutes, and 5 minutes, we are done. I'm dumping in the other lot of milk into T2. I'm gonna give that a quick stir for completeness, and I'm gonna check out, please be a negative number, and it is a positive number. What have I? No, that's right. I want a positive number because this one's hotter than that one. I forgot which way around I put it. That's fantastic. So by putting 2.2, 2.3. So around 2.25, 2.25 degrees, T1 is 2.25 degrees warmer than T2 because I put the milk in first. It lost heat slower. It radiated less heat compared to the other tea, and it has actually ended up warmer. That's so good. That's actual mass in practice and in reality. Oh, that's pretty warm. That's good, actually. That's quite good. And this one over here. Oh, that's much colder. Oh, that's tepid. I genuinely can't tell the difference. Hang on. I've totally convinced myself that this one is hotter. Okay, let's check it out in absolute terms. So we switch over. T1, where's T1? Is 58 and falling. Wow, so about 58 degrees, and the other one is 61. So there you go. So T1 is 61.4 and T2 is 58, look at that. So, I mean, either I've convinced myself, I'm very open to suggestions, or you genuinely can taste the difference over just 5 minutes change. So there you are. I took some maths, I took some physics that for ages I've told people about the theory, and finally I've checked and it does work. Believe in the fourth power. I should have said, may the fourth power be with you. I'm an idiot. One last quick thing. The only way to be guaranteed scaldingly hot tea is if you drink it out of a mug like this, which I have carefully altered so that it itself is powered and it keeps the tea constantly boiling while you drink it. You might think that sounds unsafe, but frankly, I'm prepared to put my body on the line for correct, proper British tea. It is sadly mains powered, which can get a little inconvenient. I'll just pop this down here, bring that up, and there, see, it's okay. That is substantially more on fire than I expected. How strong must tea be if it burns?